7:21 here, Big 550 KTRS. Mike Keogh is our guest. He is a state senator. Mike Keogh, you're a Republican from which district?
6th Senatorial.
And that includes Jefferson City, Columbia, as well as parts of Lake of the Ozarks?
No, it does include parts of Lake of the Ozarks. It's Cole County is the base, which is where the capital is, and we have three counties to the east and three counties to the west, but we're all below south of the Missouri River, so okay. We don't go all the way up into Boone County.
All right. You were born and raised here in St. Louis?
Yes, sir. Yeah. North St. Louis.
How'd you end up out there?
You've ever heard of a guy named Dave Sinclair?
I have, yes.
Well, he kind of helped raise me, and thanks to Mr. Sinclair, I was able to acquire a Ford and Lincoln franchise down in Jefferson City and married a girl from Chicago, and we moved down there.
All right, good for you. All right, so first let's talk roads, because in the state of Missouri, everyone complains about the traffic congestion. Everyone complains about the quality of the roads. But they tried to pass a gas tax. They tried to pass a sales tax. Nobody wants to pay for the roads.
No.
And everyone complains about the roads.
Right.
So what do we do?
80% of Missourians feel roads need funding, and only 20% of them wants to pay for them. It's a sad statistic. The highway department has done a great job of getting our roads in good condition all across the state, thanks to Amendment 3, which Missourians did pass back in 2004. And that's kind of created the problem, because the average person's driving down the road saying, other than congestion maybe on I-70,
right,
they're saying, hey, these roads are pretty good. They're pretty smooth. We've got rumble strips now. We got median guard cables. The roads are safer, and then they are. But what we know is the department knows is that the roads are deteriorating underneath. We have 10,400 bridges and 34,000 miles of center lane roads. That's the 7th largest in the country, but we're 43rd in funding in center lane per mile. So the recipe for the future years coming as those roads deteriorate just is not working.
So where do we go from here, since nobody wants to do anything?
Well, everything's got to be put back on the table. Unfortunately, bridges have been closing over the last 60 and 90 days in the state. And as those bridges close and those detours go from a couple of miles to 20 miles down a gravel road, I think you'll start to see Missourians say, well, wait a minute, we've got a problem. And
MoDOT,
I hate to get to that point.
MoDOT has basically said, look, we're going to have to start prioritizing, right? And we're going to have to do bigger projects and sort of keep the smaller ones off to the side.
Well, what they said is they're going to take their budget, which is less than a fourth of what it was in 2009 because of falling gas tax revenues, et cetera, federal government monies. And they said, instead of trying to make an impact on those 34,000 miles of roads, we're going to concentrate on 8,000 miles of connecting roads between cities and communities and try to make an impact on that. It makes sense. You have fewer resources. You'll make a bigger impact on a smaller footprint.
What about tolls?
Yeah.
Well, that's been a conversation. Interestingly enough, I had toll road legislation in 2012 in the General Assembly. Federal government has given us a waiver that we could impose a toll or a public-private partnership on I-70 if the state so choose. But Missourians just aren't ready for that. It's 36 other states use that as a form to fund transportation. It doesn't solve the whole problem. It's a corridor fix. But 60% of Missouri's population lives either 30 miles north or 30 miles south of I-70, and that just freaks them out when you start talking about that.
Well, and the other thing is then you float the idea of, great, we'll have a toll road from Wentzville to Independence, and you're not gonna toll the biggest people who use Highway 70 the most.
Yeah, but you know, the other thing about I-70 is that St. Louis and Kansas City are the third and second largest rail hubs in the United States, and that's a good thing because we're moving a lot of freight back and forth. So that's what you're seeing moving back and forth on 70. With the expansion of the Panama Canal, we're going to have some unbelievable container opportunities coming up the Mississippi River. So we need to figure this problem out, because we want to keep that connection. Those trucks are commerce moving back across our state, and the economic impact they provide to our businesses is incredible. So we got to figure that out.
Mike Keogh, state senator from Cole County, I guess is the best way to put it. If you could wave a magic wand and get everyone talking down in Jefferson City onto the same page, how would you like to fund the roads going forward?
Well, I think I was actually in favor of the sales tax back in August, and that's not a popular thing for a Republican conservative who hates taxes to go forward. But 11 other states have adopted that, and the reason is because gas tax funding continues to be volatile as the price of gas goes up and down, and people are buying less gas, cars are getting more fuel efficient, less gas tax revenue is coming in, and now we have electric cars, which we'll talk about in a minute here.
Right.
And it's not just Tesla who makes them. Ford makes them, Honda makes them, GM makes them. As people buying those cars, they're not paying any kind of tax to run that car on the road. So we got to start figuring out a way to capture the use of some of these vehicles that are not traditionally gas-powered, and see if there's a way to do that. Missourians didn't like that approach, so we're going to have to figure out a different way to skin the cat.
Let's talk Tesla. They've been in the news. The Dealers of Missouri, which I'm assuming you're a part of,
yes,
is now suing the Department of Revenue for allowing Tesla to come in and sell cars here in Missouri. There's been some confusion. Is there a law that says they must have some type of franchise license to sell cars in Missouri?
Yeah, that's what the dealer's beef is. In 1980, there was a couple of sections of law passed of the Motor Vehicle Franchise Practicing Act. It's in two different chapters, 407 and 301. And what it says is that if you're going to be a licensed dealer, it's a consumer protection piece that way before me they passed. That says you're going to have a facility, you're going to have a service department, you're going to have a way to take care of customers. If you're going to be a franchise dealer, you have to sell so many vehicles a year. There's requirements to be a franchise dealer. Tesla decided not to pay attention to that. They want to go factory direct. Hey, I'm all for selling Teslas. I'm all for the technology. I think it's a great piece. But from a consumer protection piece, I don't think consumers understand what will happen down the road when that car has problems, when that car has a recall, or if Tesla were just running into financial problems, what are they going to do with that vehicle?
Why did the state of Missouri and the Department of Revenue give Tesla a license to sell these cars if the law states all you other dealers must have a license?
Well, the Department of Revenue is mum. The only thing we can tell from them is that the directive came from the second floor of the Capitol, and that's from the governor's office. Tesla is heavily subsidized by federal government subsidies, our taxpayer dollars. $30,000 a car goes to every Tesla you see driving down the street. And we believe that there was some pressure put on the governor's office from the feds to let these people open up in the state of Missouri. There's no other explanation. When you look at Tesla's dealer license, which we've sunshined, the first one they put in got rejected. They sent it back to them, and then they filled out the form a little differently, and the second one got accepted. So somebody was obviously walking them through, here's the right boxes you got to check, here's the lines you got to fill out in order to become a franchise
dealer.
Certainly
other states are not allowing this, or
well,
are they?
Michigan has, the governor signed into law just in the last month, that in order to sell cars in the state, you have to be a franchise dealer. Texas is undertaking it. Many, many states across the union are doing the same thing because everybody needs to be on the same playing field. We can't create this special second tier for a government-subsidized company that existing dealers who are in your neighborhood, who you go to church with, who your kids play soccer with, have been abiding by for 40 years.
We were talking off the air as you were getting ready on, and you were quoting something from Tesla's own report.
Yeah.
Tesla's
SEC report that just came out this week says in black and white, this is not me making this up, that they do not have intentions to have service facilities where their customers are located, and they don't have a way to service those vehicles other than the regional service centers. For Missouri, that's in Chicago. And that car goes on a flatbed truck, it disappears for a long time, and then it comes back. They're trying to take care of the customer when they do that, but I have a friend in Jefferson City who actually has one, and he's had it up there six times. He just keeps it in his garage right now. And he's the same guy saying, when this franchise law came up, I thought you politicians were crazy, but now I'm mad that I don't have a way to, he doesn't have any remedy to
right.
take care of this problem.
Yeah. So where do we go from here? How long does this lawsuit go on?
Well, yeah, it's obviously in the court's hands now, and it'll probably take several months for that to get through.
Yeah.
And again, at the end of the day, we hope that Teslas are sold in Missouri, but we want you to be able to go to Fuse or Bomarito or Sinclair or SunTrup or somebody that
you
know.
Don't forget Johnny Londoff.
Oh, Johnny Londoff.
Holy mackerel. You got to take care of Johnny Londoff.
Yeah, I like Johnny. He's a great guy. But anyway, some of those great names that you know, and every community has those types of names that are established in their metropolitan markets, that those folks are going to take care of you no matter what happens to the manufacturer, because they're the ones that have the relationship with you.
Mike Keogh, Missouri State Senator from Cole County, on the show with us. Lots of interesting things going on. Mike, you're always welcome here.
Hey, I'm happy to be here this morning. I hope to come back.
You got it. You're one of the few who haven't tried to sue me down there, so that's good.
No, I'm not. I'm not a litigious person. I'm a small business guy. We don't like that.
There you go. 731 here, Big 550. K.